Welcome back. It's me, the D-O-double-G, and by my side is jail pretty Josh Matthews. I recycled that one because I liked it so much. And I sure hope you like pain because we're about to bring you a fist helmet full of it.
Well, my colleague is correct in his description. Are you serious? Is the foulest thing to hit the internet since Anthony Weiner stopped tweeting.
You got to be careful when playing with your tweeter.
Wait, what?
You heard me.
I think it's time for our first clip before you get in any more trouble.
This week's superstar recall is T.L. Hopper. As a plumber, T.L. Hopper was tasked with the proper maintenance of sewage systems. Judging by the crap dumped into the WWE ring in the early 90s, you'd think he'd have his work cut out for him. But he was flushed faster than a post-bender growler.
Watching this is more unpleasant than a case of hot snakes.
Do you think the plumbers call it a TL Hopper crack?
Hey! TL Hopper here. How y'all doing out there? Here to talk to you a little bit about plumbing. A fine art of plumbing. When my old Betty here plunging in the
head. I hadn't understood a word he said. And I have my IFB in.
All over the world. You know why? I'm the best at it. After T.L. Hopper, best dead blame plumber in the world.
He was the best dead blame plumber in the world.
Best dang on plumber in the world.
Why do you have to say it like that? Because he's from the South?
Well, what kind of plumber? Yeah.
I mean, that's a pretty serious statement. He's the best dead blame plumber in the world. Here you are making jokes, regional jokes, mind you. You think you're safe because you're sitting up here in New York City.
Well, we are.
New York City?
We are locked in a vault.
In Stamford.
Get down into the green and the dirt and the grime and the sludge and everything of the problem up there.
I wonder if he has doo-doo under his fingernails.
That old fella, that pretty little fella there, they call him,
No job is too big or too messy for T.L. Hopper.
He must never have seen the Big Show's bathroom. One Night Stand, the pay-per-view first inspired by the hell-raising, rule-smashing theatrics of ECW, a night where superstars forgot the rules and go full tilt crazy.
On this particular night in 2008, Melina was heading out to the ring to face Beth Phoenix in an I Quit match. The former MNM valet was flanked by a team of paparazzi.
Whether overcome by the diva's stunning looks or just not used to putting one foot in front of the other, one of the unlucky photographers got his gams crossed and turned his One Night Stand into a lifetime fail.
Watch out there, the paparazzi getting a little overexcited, and I don't blame them. This entrance of Melina's is enough to excite anyone. Watch this photographer here. Easy, big fella.
Whoa, he walks like Amanda Bynes drives.
Every night we switch our browsers to private and scour the Twitter land for feedback and suggestions from the WWE Universe. This one comes to us from Bobcat013, who asked for this classic moment from the height of WCW.
What's up with Hogan sunglasses? Those are the most uncool sunglasses I have to cover his Betty Davis eyes, I guess.
Wasn't he friends with Dennis Rodman? Maybe he borrowed them from him.
NWO is just too
What's in the box? Let's guess.
A new toupee for Bischoff?
Vince Russo's career?
Santa with muscles on DVD?
A year's worth of gift cards to Pasta Mania.
Ah! It has more facial expressions than I do.
I have a Billy Kidman head just like that at home.
That's weird and random, and you have to wonder, with Hulk Hogan's acting skills, why High Noon at Mega Mountain wasn't a bigger hit.
It's really cool. You should see it. It's in a box just like that.
What the hell are you talking about?
Billy Kidman's head.
Is Bret Hart trying to save? How did Bret know that Hogan was going to be wearing those sunglasses?
It's Sting. Sting has arrived on the scene.
Hold on just a second there, Hulk. I'll be right down. Just give me a minute.
He's like 3 feet above the fans.
And he that went like, wasn't even Sting, by the way.
He was going.
That like, was a stunt double.
Like 1 mile an hour.
We'll see you Sunday at Starcade.
I guess they ran out of money or time was up on that episode.
You know, speaking of running out of.